All right, welcome to the video. I'm going to be looking at a couple of different ways to isolate vocals and instruments from a single audio source. I'm going to be looking at Splitter through a Colab notebook. I'm going to be looking at Melody.ml, Moises.ai, and Unmix. I chose this video here. It's the most popular music video on YouTube right now, and it's new and trending, so I thought I'd just try this. So to start off here, I'll be using NVIDIA RTX Voice. This runs in real time and uses machine learning. So let's try it.
All I go just so don't feel righteous. I know that the truth is hard to digest. 5 or 6 pills in my right hand.
Okay, so we can see it does a pretty good job at getting the music out and isolating the voice, but it does have some artifacts and cuts out the voice at times, and there is a little bit of leakage of music underneath, which is to be expected. These aren't perfect. All right, now I will be using the pre-trained Splitter four-stem separator. The four-stem means that it separates it into vocals, drums, bass, and other. I'm using the pre-trained Splitter four-stem model, but if you wanted to, you could train your own model if you have a specific use case that you would like to use Splitter with. For example, if you have a specific genre that you would like to extract stems with, you could do that. And actually, what Splitter does is pretty amazing because not only does it identify which instruments belong to which category from the sample, but it actually extracts them pretty well. Okay, so now I have all the wave files downloaded, so let's take a look at them. I'll start off with the vocals.
All I go just so don't feel righteous. I know that the truth is hard to digest. 5 or 6 pills in my right hand. Codeine running over on my nightstand. Taking medicine to fix all of the damage. My anxiety, the size of a planet.
Okay, so we can see that it does a pretty good job, but it seems to leak a little bit more of the instrumental than RTX Voice did, which is interesting. But as a bonus, we can see how it did with some other things. So let's take a look at the drums at around the same time. Starts at 30 seconds. So yeah, it does a pretty good job at getting the kick and the clap and the hi-hats. Yeah, pretty good job. Now let's take a look at the bass. So far, bad. I wasn't really paying attention to the bass in the song, but it sounds pretty good. Might be missing out on the. Actually, it sounds like it's missing out on quite a bit of the higher frequencies, but let's check out the other. So this seems to be the melody, the guitar. It does a pretty good job at that. I don't hear his voice like at all. Well, I hear it a little bit, but it's pretty good. I don't hear any bass. I hear a little bit of the hi-hats. Those seem to be the hardest to get rid of. All right, now I want to compare against Open Unmix. One cool thing about this notebook, which is provided on their GitHub, which I will link in the description, I took their notebook and I tweaked it so that I could, I think so I could train or something. I don't really remember, but one cool thing about it is that you can just put in the YouTube URL and it'll download it automatically. But this is the result.
All I Gucci suit, I'm feeling righteous. Yeah. I know that the truth is hard to digest. Yeah. 5 or 6 pills in my right hand. Yeah. Codeine running over on my nightstand. Taking medicine to fix all of the damage. My anxiety the size of a planet.
So pretty clean vocals, but it does let in, again, the hi-hats, but this one seems to let in more of the snare or the clap. I don't remember what it was, but the vocals seem to be a little bit crisper, but they do let in a little bit more of the drums. So as bonus, we can take a look at the drums again. This one does a pretty okay job, but I feel like Spleeter did a better job at isolating the drums. So let's take a look at the bass. It sounds lower quality than what Spleeter did, but it might have, I don't know, I think Spleeter did a better job overall. Open Unmix might have done a better job at isolating the melody there, the guitar. So good job on that. So there's actually some online implementations of this, and one is melody.ml, here's the URL, and the other one is moises.ai. So I'm going to be comparing it to these two as well. I think this one might, yeah, this one uses Deezer Spleeter. I'm not sure if they have a, I'm not sure if they trained their own model for it or not, but I'm going to compare and we'll find out. This doesn't have a link for what they use, but yeah. So I used melody.ml and I was pretty impressed with how quickly they were able to process it. And they just, there was just a download link that I could click on the same page and it gave me a zip file with all the stems in it. So let's look at the vocals.
All I Gucci suit, I'm feeling righteous. Yeah. I know that the truth is hard to digest. Yeah. 5 or 6 pills in my right hand. Yeah. Codeine running over on my nightstand. Taking medicine to fix all of the damage. My anxiety the size of a planet.
So yeah, it sounds like it probably does use Spleeter, just the pre-trained. Let's take a look at the drums and see if it does as well as in the collab notebook. Yeah, I'd guess that it just uses the pre-trained, which is not bad because then that means that you can just use their website, and I recommend it. Works pretty well. All right, so using Moises right now, I selected the YouTube link and I selected 4 stems, so let's try it out. And now we wait. All right, now let's take a look at moises.ai.
All I Gucci suit, I'm feeling righteous. Yeah. I know that the truth is hard to digest.
Yeah, if I had to guess, I'd say that both of these websites are using the pre-trained 4-stem Spleeter neural network. Yeah. Yeah, it sounds pretty similar. So if you want, if you don't want a complicated notebook, you don't want to mess with Python, just use these websites. They work pretty well.